5, 4, 3, 2.
Yugi Bros!
Guys, this is a part 2 to my Let's Errata Some Skills video. If you guys haven't seen part 1 yet or would like to, I'll leave a link in the description down below for you to go check that one out. But with that out of the way, let's continue this video, shall we?
Flight of the Harpies says if you lose 1800 or more life, you can activate the skill during your next draw phase. During your draw phase, you may search your deck for a Harpy card, reveal it to your opponent, add it to your hand instead of drawing it. If you do, flip this card over. This is literally Destiny Draw, except 1800 is all you have to lose instead of 2000. But what I don't understand is why wouldn't you just play Destiny Draw for an extra 200 life and get any card instead of a Harpy card? Again, it needs to be reworded just so people can clarify how that whole thing works. But I would change 18 to something a lot less than 18. Maybe 1,000. Because Harpies, it's only as good as the Harpy cards it's searching. And since you're limited to Harpies, 1,000 might even be too much. Maybe change it to 800, honestly. Like, would it be insane if it said just once per turn, instead of conducting a normal draw, add a Harpy card from your deck to your hand? Would that be too good? I mean, obviously that would come with you can only use this card's effect like 2 or 3 times per duel. But I don't think that would be insane. And then I think Harpies have a solid search card. I don't know. Fury of Thunder. Activate the following skills during your main phase while you control Slife of the Sky Dragon. Draw until you have 4 cards in your hand. That's pretty cool. If Slife of the Sky Dragon is sent to the graveyard, you can shuffle it back into the deck. Each of these skills can only be used once per duel. I think it's fine. I think this is a little weak. I mean, once Slifer dies. Do you really want it back in your deck to draw it later as a brick? I mean, I guess it depends what you're playing. No, I think it's fine. Fusion Party. Activate this skill during your main phase. Once per duel, you can fusion summon 1 fusion monster from your extra deck using monsters from your hand or field as fusion material. This is why this card is terrible. It's Palmerization once a turn, but it's once per duel. Make it once per turn. Would it be the worst thing if it was once per turn? Maybe over time, in which case, change once per turn, but only can be used 2 or 3 times per duel. I think 2 is just not enough. I would say 3 is fine, but then like, when are you ever gonna use it more than 3 times, you know? Maybe 2. Gravekeeper's Lot. This is the same as Flight of the Harpies and Destiny Draw. If you lose 1800 or more life, blah, 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 during your draw phase, add a Gravekeeper card. Again, just change this to like 800. Like 800 life, reword it so it makes more sense. Grit. At the start of your turn, call 2 numbers and roll a 6-sided dice. I remember this. If you roll a number you called, your life points do not get lower than 1 until the end of your opponent's next turn. The skill can only be used once per duel. This card's hilarious. Why would anyone play this, though? It has a very good chance of not working. Like, I don't see the point of making it once per duel when the worst that happens is you just don't lose. It basically wabakoos you, but you still take damage. You just don't go lower than 1. Which screws up a bunch of math. Why not once per turn call 2 numbers since it can miss, and then you gain that effect for the rest of the turn, or until the end of your opponent's next turn? I think it's fine. Guardians of the Tomb. During your opponent's main phase, when a monster is special summoned from your spell and trap zone to your field while you have no cards in your hand, you can draw 1 card, and if you do, you can set 1 spell or trap from your hand. This skill can only be used once per turn. Do you really need no cards in your hand for this to be perfectly balanced? Like, it's basically saying if you top deck a spell or trap card, you can set it. But you're setting on your opponent's turn, so you can't use it. Either keep this effect and say that set card can be used this turn, because you already have to have the no cards in hand for it to be relevant. Yeah, I know you could just fill your deck with trap monsters and stuff, and it would always be viable, but like, you're sacrificing your skill slot, which could otherwise be like something more mainstream, for this already. So if the point of it is you're playing a bunch of trap monsters, so you're most likely going to draw a trap monster with this effect, and then you can set it and then use it that turn, is that really the worst? The only time I could see this be busted right now is with Zoma the Spirit. But if we implement a ban list system or a limited list and we put Zoma to like 1 or something, then this skill's perfectly fine, even with this card saying you can activate the set spell trap that you just set. Heavy Metal Raiders. Perfect example of a field spell that just should be outside the game. First time, each dark machine monster you control would be destroyed by battle. Each turn, it is not destroyed. And if you took battle damage from the battle, it gains that much attack after damage calculation and keeps that attack gain as long as this card is on the field. This would be mitigated if it was outside the game. It would just say, and keeps that attack. You don't even need this extra effect here. And then once per turn, if a monster you control that was originally a Dark Machine monster destroys a card or cards on the field by battle or card effect, you can special summon a Dark Machine monster from your hand. Guys, I tried so hard to make this card relevant. I think this card is fantastic if it's outside the game. If it plays like outside the game, like Inner Conflict or Twisted Personality or like most skills. Don't make it a field spell. Don't start with one less card in your hand. Just keep this outside the game. This card, machines would be relevant. Dark machines would be relevant. Like as a deck, as just a pure deck. You know what else is a dark machine? Jinzo. Can you imagine you have, I don't know, Twin Barrel Dragon pop a card and you special summon a Jinzo from your hand? And I know some people are like, man, this is probably too good if you leave it outside the game. Okay, fine. Just let us try it, right? We have Cocoon of Ultra Evolution, guys. We have Inner Conflict, guys. More broken skills are not the end of the world. This wouldn't make a tier 0 format, but this deck would definitely become strong as hell. But then that's also what a ban list is for. If it gets too overpowered and too oppressive, you ban it. And you wait, you know, until it gets less powerful. Hidden Parasite. Once per turn, you can change all monsters on the field to insect until the end of the turn. Also, any battle damage your opponent takes is halved for the rest of the turn. You may use this skill up to twice per duel. This is a perfect example of a skill that I think is perfectly fine. Because Eradicating Aerosol exists, that turns this skill into a dark hole if you draw Eradicating Aerosol. And you can use it twice per duel. It's not once per duel. If it was once per duel, I think this card would be a lot worse. But twice per duel, perfectly fine, perfectly balanced. I love this card. Erratic Chant. Activate the skill during your main phase. Discard your entire hand, minimum one. Add one, the Winged Dragon of Ra, from your deck or graveyard to your hand. And if you do, you can tribute summon one monster during your main phase this turn, in addition to your normal summon slash set. That's probably fine. Hyper Metamorphosis. You can activate this skill while you control a level 3 or lower insect normal monster. I hate that it says that. Discard two cards, that's also a huge cost, and tribute one level 3 or lower normal insect monster, again, hate that it says that you control, to special summon one perfectly ultimate great moth from your hand or deck, ignoring its summoning conditions. Any damage your opponent takes for the rest of the turn is halved. Obviously, as you guys know, so this came out in the Ultimate Predators starter deck, and then later on we got Cocoon of Ultra Evolution in Trials of the Kingdom, and Cocoon of Ultra Evolution is just literally better than this. Like, this has so many extra hurdles to go through, and Cocoon doesn't. And, again, you don't need normal monsters, you don't need to discard two cards, you don't need to also tribute that normal monster, you get this. All you need, oh yeah, and your opponent takes half damage for the rest of the turn. Man. You'd have to do so much to Hyper Metamorphosis to make it better. I guess, like, realistically, why not just say, tribute a level 3 or lower insect monster you control, discard one card to summon this, and it's once per duel. Yeah, but this is justified if you're dropping it 3,500 from your deck for free. I don't know, I'm trying to make this skill worth playing so that Cocoon of Ultra Evolution could get banned so that we could just play this if we were going to play an insect deck. Like, at least with this card, you're forced, if you're playing Perfect Ultimate Great Moth, you're forced to play insects. I guess if you just have one level 3 or lower, you're not forced to play insects. So maybe if it said, tribute an insect monster you control and discard an insect monster you from your hand to special summon, that way you have to have at least two or more. Yeah, I guess you could still send two Parasite Paranoids, but either way at that point, then, you know, it's not just free. So this could be fine, probably. I'm just gonna attack. I hate these names. I think these names are very lazy. Like, even if Joy Wheeler literally just says, I'm just gonna attack, like, give it a little more pizzazz, you know? Apply the following skills. During your main phase, you can make one monster you control. Gain 100 attack until the end of the turn. That's awful. It's just straight awful. During your battle phase, when your opponent activates a trap, you can negate its effect and set that card. That's not awful, but it sucks that it doesn't gain any advantage. The only advantage you gain is that trap not being able to be used this turn, but it's still there for next turn. I would probably change this to 500, because that's a little bit more substantial. Then, this is probably fine. I hate that you, again, you still don't gain advantage, but 500 is better than 100, and negating a trap technically is cool. I think it'd be fine if you just buff this. Inner Conflict. Activate the skill during your main phase. Once per duel, you can pay half your life points and take control of one monster your opponent controls until the end phase, but it cannot attack directly this turn. if you change it to it cannot attack directly this turn or be tributed, I think this card is fine. I don't know if Speedduel's plans to ever go beyond fusions and give us synchros and XYZs and stuff like that. And then again, this card would become a problem. So if it does plan on going that route, maybe just change it to, instead of paying half, pay 1,000 or pay 2,000, maybe 1,500. 2,000 is so crazy with 4,000 life points. I never agree with things that pay half because that means they're always viable. Maybe if it said pay 1,500 to do the same thing, but then it also can't be tributed so that it kind of becomes useless now. But over time with synchros and XYZs, if we go that route, then it's still good. It's just not insanely oppressive again. I don't know. I don't want to nerf it so much that it's unplayable. So again, as of right now, I think all you need to do is change it to cannot attack directly this turn, also cannot be tributed. Simple, effective, easy, done.
Well, guys, that concludes this part of this multiple part series. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe as always. Click that notification bell to get all of our latest updates. And hey, if you have any suggestions or changes that you would make compared to what I did, please let me know down below, and let's have a discussion about this, shall we?